why are you so tilted?
Today we're gonna find out exactly how good metal straws are. Are they environmentally friendly and are they user friendly? I've been using this set since I bought it 2 weeks ago, in addition to 3 other sets that I will be giving away at the end of this video. So stay tuned to find out how you can win them. Here's step 1, subscribe. The fact that I'm giving these away kind of gives away what I think about them, which is obviously positive. But I bought these from BYOB Singapore. I really want to mention them because normally metal straws can cost upwards of $5, but BYO bottle really makes them more affordable, which is awesome if you're a broke student like me. Okay, now let's talk about straws. This year seems to be the year we finally kick our bad habit of using disposable straws. Early in July, Seattle became the largest US city to ban plastic straws. Starbucks will get rid of all its plastic straws by 2020, and the United Kingdom is set to ban all single-use plastics by as early as next year. This includes plastic straws and cotton buds. So, how did this year lead to the final straw? Well, we've all heard of reduce, reuse, recycle. And when it comes to straws, groups like Straw-Free and Lonely Whale have been very active in promoting a straw-free lifestyle. And then there was this video.
She's going to be so happy. A big booger.
I think that video struck a chord in us because we finally saw the consequences of our actions. Personally, as a recovering bubble tea addict, I have happily poked plastic straws through plastic cups without thinking where all of it ends up. So where do they end up? Firstly, we all know how flimsy plastic straws are. It's very easy for them to break down into microplastics, which are small enough to pass through water filtration systems into the ocean, where they could be mistaken for food. They join a whole gang of other plastics that pose a danger to marine life. I'm sure you've seen animals getting trapped in plastic rings or mistaking plastic bags for food. The thing about microplastics is, we might be consuming them too. Plastic pieces are starting to appear in seafood, and in an analysis of 259 bottles of water from 11 different brands in 9 different countries, 90% of the bottles contain microplastic. There was even one bottle with a concentration of 10,000 pieces of plastic per liter of water. I mean, what are you doing? And if you consider that in America alone, 500 million straws are being used every single day. That's equal to about 127 school buses going to school every single day. Imagine how much of that is swirling in our oceans now. It's not easy to recycle plastics because there are so many different kinds. Polystyrene, polypropylene, PET.
Just kidding, not that PET.
And they each require specific chemical processes to break down. If there's even one piece of plastic where it shouldn't be, the entire batch gets contaminated. And let's be honest, how many of us actually sort our trash based on the specific type of plastic? Raise your hand, touch your heart. Guilty! Obviously, we also can't just burn plastic because that releases dioxin, which is a highly toxic environmental pollutant. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why we have so much plastic swimming in our oceans. So, the million-dollar question. Are metal straws that extraordinary? Granted, this is not a straw, but the other straws in the drink, so. If you buy metal straws made of food-grade stainless steel, it's essentially like cutlery. Compared to single-use plastics and utensils, obviously the metal options would be more sustainable in the long run if you commit to using them. Of course, even though going metal, recycle your paper plates, your soda cans, and your plastic bottles, is more environmentally friendly, producing them still incurs environmental costs. So we should really only buy what we need. Like antibiotics, hashtag throwback. I hope you still remember that. Also, there's the big issue of accessibility. Disabled individuals may not be able to lift their arms to tilt a cup. So spilling is a problem they have to deal with, and bendy plastic straws solve that. The issue with bending plastic straws is that it further reduces the freedom that a disabled person has. It's also not as easy as just asking them to bring their own, because having limited mobility means it's difficult to pack one and take it out whenever they need it. So the more balanced position we should advocate for now is for businesses to keep a small supply of plastic straws on hand for the disabled community. The rest of us obviously shouldn't abuse this. It's important that we keep ourselves accountable for the environment, and that includes the people around us. Speaking of accountability, reducing our plastic straws is only the first step in being sustainable. Plastic straws make up less than 1% of the 8 million metric tons of plastic that goes into our oceans every year. The biggest source of plastic pollution is actually fishing gear. But of course, that's a cause that's a little harder to get behind.
Welcome to the annual Miss Sustainable Pageant. Today we have contestants 1 and 2 with us. So contestant number 1, how would you be more sustainable?
I believe we should all stop eating seafood and fishing with plastic gear.
Okay, and contestant number 2, how would you be more sustainable?
Well, I believe we should all stop sucking.
And that's the thesis.
So if metal straws don't make that much of a difference, what's the point? Well, compared to fishing gear, plastic straws are something most of us use almost every day. The hope is, once we start rejecting plastic straws, we'll also get used to rejecting plastic cups, bags, and other single-use disposables. That would make our sustainable efforts even more effective. One last thing you might want to watch out about metal straws is that they are solid metal.
Why'd I do that?
If you are someone who chews your straw as much as you chew the pearls in bubble tea, your first experience with a metal straw might be pretty memorable if you aren't careful. Maybe someone could invent a silicone mouthpiece that we could attach to the top of our metal straws. I wonder how feasible that would be. Any thoughts? Lastly, make sure you buy your metal straws from credible sellers. I'd say look out for sellers who are clear advocates for environmental friendliness. Now, if you're here to win a metal straw set, all you have to do is subscribe and leave a comment below about how you would cut down on plastic waste. It could be one sentence, one essay, whatever floats your boat. This giveaway will last for about a month, so look forward to the results in October. Bye!